Hey everyone, welcome back to the channel. This is the 75 Corrupt Cops Who've Crossed the Line. Please remember to like, subscribe, and share the videos. Hit the notification bell and you'll know when a new video comes out. I'm getting better at that, right? Didn't have to repeat it 5 times. All right. This is a real disturbing video. And two cops were charged in this, in what I think should never have been brought as a charge. If this happens, they've been indicted and charged. If these guys get convicted and go to jail, the job is practically dead now because of all the defund the police bullshit and everything else that's going on. 99% of cops out there do the right thing. And this has nothing to do with corruption or anything else. This is just cops out there doing their job. And once again, I think it's an overreach on the government that they indicted and charged these cops. All right, so this happened back last year, October 23rd, 2020. And it's just cops doing their job. This is 3 o'clock in the morning. Washington, D.C., officers find a reckless moped driver. It's 3 o'clock in the morning. He's riding on the sidewalk, total disregard for any type of traffic laws, anything like that. They attempt to pull him over. And obviously, he doesn't want to get pulled over, and he drives more recklessly. All right, so like I said, it happened October. These guys were... charges were just made on them September 23rd. They were indicted by a grand jury, so they were arrested. The first officer is a 10-year veteran. His name was Terrence Sutton, 37 years old. He was charged with second-degree murder, conspiracy, and obstruction of justice. The second officer was Andrew Zabeski. If I pronounce that right. He was a lieutenant, 18-year veteran. He was charged with conspiracy and obstruction of justice. I think this is outrageous. I mean, these guys were out there just trying to protect the public of a reckless driver, someone driving. Even though it was 3 a.m, there were pedestrians out. Obviously, other vehicles were out on the road. At any time, and this is a... the driver of this moped, his name was Hilton Brown, 20 years old. So he's not a young kid where he doesn't know traffic laws, doesn't know better, doesn't know he needs to pull over when cops attempt to stop him. At any time, Hilton Brown could have pulled over and just stopped and complied with officers attempting to, protect people from a reckless driver. Complete reckless driver. This is not on the cops. So what happens is they attempt to pull him over. He flees. He drives more recklessly. He's driving up and down sidewalks. He's going wrong way down one-way streets. He drives through an alley. And when he comes out the end of the alley, he blindlessly blows a stop sign as he's done in this. It was like a 3-minute pursuit. Went about 10 blocks. He disregarded all types of stop signs and everything. At the end of this alley, he blindly went into an intersection, and there was cross traffic of a civilian vehicle. It has nothing to do with a police vehicle or RMPs, nothing like that. And the two officers that were attempting to pull him over, they were in separate vehicles. They're not even in the same vehicle. So Hilton Brown blindlessly goes into the intersection and slams into a pickup truck that was crossing the intersection. Cops immediately stopped. They tried to provide first aid, all that type of stuff. Months go by and federal charges go against Terrence Sutton, Officer Sutton, for second degree murder. The indictment says, this is weird because I read the indictment and it says the moped only had a top speed of 30 miles per hour. But then further in the indictment, it says officers chased him at speeds reaching up to 45 miles per hour. So, I mean, they're already contradicting themselves. If the moped only has a top speed of 30 miles an hour, how are they reaching speeds of up to 45 miles an hour chasing him? I don't know. So all that went on. It also further says in the indictment that Officer Sutton, who was hit with the second degree murder charge, operated his motor vehicle in total disregard of death and serious injury to Hilton Brown, who was riding the moped recklessly, who started this whole thing. So I have no idea how they're going to justify a second degree murder charge. I mean, I think it's ridiculous. It's outrageous. And if this ever goes through and these cops are convicted, you'll never have cops ever chase anyone for anything. Robberies, rapes, who knows what, drug shootings. I don't think they got to be crazy to chase somebody. You're chasing somebody, you're not driving the speed limit. You have to drive at pursuit operation, which every cop goes through pursuit training through the academy. And there's always, I think it's yearly, where you go back to retrain for firearms and for vehicle pursuit training. So the one who didn't have any type of training clearly is Hilton Brown, who died at the scene when he disobeyed all types of traffic laws and slammed into a civilian vehicle. So I don't see where this is going. I'd love to hear you guys comment on this and give me your opinions down in the comment section. Do you guys agree with this? Do you think the officer should have been charged? And the conspiracy and obstruction of justice charges come in. They're saying that the two officers conspired to somehow change the reason why they were trying to stop him. It doesn't really go into what they did or said or anything like that. I'm pretty sure as soon as you start to chase somebody, it goes out over the radio. Plus there's two body cam footage and there's also dash cam footage. I got the body cam footage for both for you guys. I'm going to put it up after this video. I didn't get the dash cam footage. You guys can probably look it up and find it. I have seen the dash cam footage. I just couldn't refine it when I went to look for it. So let me know what you think. Like, these guys deserve to be hit with murder charges, second degree murder charges. I don't see any manslaughter. I don't see nothing. They were doing their job. They're supposed to pull people over that are driving recklessly. That's part of the requirement of the job. So I don't get it. When you put pursuits over the air, sometimes supervisors will say terminate the pursuit, which you do. Apparently, this didn't happen in this situation. Again, it was 3 o'clock in the morning, and he's driving recklessly where he could have, and I'm talking Hilton Brown was driving recklessly with the moped, where he could have injured the pedestrians on the sidewalk and you know, other vehicles, which is what he does. He slams into another car. So he slams into a pickup truck, thankfully only caused an injury to himself. He could have slammed into who knows what, a motorcycle going by, people walking across the intersection, a smaller vehicle where somebody could have been injured in that civilian vehicle. So cops are charged. And we'll see where this goes. I think cops across the country are going to be following this. And already union reps are, outraged over this. And the lawyer for one of the officers already spoke out on a news interview. So, again, let me know what you guys think. Appreciate you guys stopping in. Stand by for the video is going to follow me talking. And, again, put down some info in the comments and let me know what you guys think. I really want to know what you guys think. And remember to give me a thumbs up. Thanks so much for stopping by. I appreciate it. So long. Bye.
Now replaying the clip without freeze frames.
Right now. Come on! Hey, see if, make it easy. Where'd that car go? Yeah. Is he, so turn him over on the side. Your license, is everybody okay?
Yeah.
Okay.